Hi.
Hey.
It's Spyro.
It's Spyro, wow.
So, for this video, some hobo broke into my house. Don't worry about that. Welcome to Peacekeeper, Spyro. Look how our it just happens sometimes.
It happens all the time. I've had the same hobo break into my house before.
Well, you're the hobo.
Yeah, but then you've been the hobo and broken into my house before.
Let's go with that. Anyway, this is Spyro.
Wow.
This is post-commentary because, I don't know, I felt like it.
I was high.
I just had to be prepared for my house to be broken into by a hobo.
I was high.
That too. Is it still considered intoxicated if you're not, like, drunk? You're just high?
If I was driving and they pulled me over and they found weed in my system, I'd be considered driving under the influence.
So I guess so, then. That what you saw just now was me, like, fucking up trying to show off an Easter egg. Or, I guess you could consider an Easter egg. Hey, look, they moon you. That's what I was trying to show off. Anyway, welcome to... Peacekeepers. The second homeworld of Spyro the Dragon.
What happened to the first one?
Oh, I did that already.
Oh.
I just did it off screen. We're just starting this Let's Play on the second homeworld, like, an hour into the game for no reason.
Why?
Because I lied and we're not actually doing that. I just haven't uploaded it yet.
Why?
Because East hasn't finished uploading yet.
Why?
M.
What if it is uploaded now?
Well, shit. I never thought of it that way. This is a cannon, by the way. It controls kind of weird because you have to actually push it with your physical being as opposed to just like pressing a button to turn it like a lot of games would have you do it. It's easy enough to do once you get used to it, but it is a little weird.
It looks weird.
But it's okay, because it is a very useful tool for destroying the world.
I, too, like to destroy the world.
Also, kind of different from the last homeworld, but in this homeworld, the boss is just kind of sitting out there. You don't need to beat any of the levels to get to it. It's just kind of in the middle of the world.
You know, I need to get back to this at some point.
Yeah. Also, Nightflight is actually, like, not hidden. Well, I guess it's kind of hidden if you're, like, really stupid or something and just didn't see the big-ass target on the rock you're supposed to break, but... You know how, like, the first world's flight is... not something that you'd really know to look for, and it's just kind of told to you how to get to it in, like, the third world.
You just saved the baby egg person.
Yeah. I was really mad when I got that thief, by the way. Or, not so much when I got the thief, but when I missed the thief, because usually that thief's one that I get, like, before it even starts running, basically. And then I choked on it and screwed up. Also, I can't hear the game because I don't want Sonic Adventure Big the Cat Syndrome to happen, where every time I talk while something happens in the game, it just kind of echoes on my mic.
Yeah.
So, I can't remember what Spyro said in that cutscene.
You said things.
Is that the one where he, like, where the other dragon cuts him off before he gets to say the word ass?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's all like, no, Spyro, you can't say the ass word. That's a swear.
This could have been an edgy T-rated game, but instead it's an edgy E-rated game. Rated E for edgy.
You know, Shadow the Hedgehog was supposed to be T-rated, but then they said, nah, they invented the E10 plus rating, so we're gonna use that instead.
Fun fact, apparently Shadow the Hedgehog was literally, like, censored at the last second, because they saw, oh wait, there's an E10 rating, so we can have a higher rating, but still have it be child-friendly. So instead of, like, instead of being, like, a proper T-rated game, it's just a normal Sonic game, but they say damn sometimes.
Pretty much.
Shadow the Hedgehog is fucking riot.
What if Shadow said fuck?
What if
would you be okay?
What if Shadow the Hedgehog was a bitch ass motherfucker who pissed on my wife?
I'd be upset if he did that to me and I'd kick his ass and then steal his gun and shoot him with it. I like this level.
I do not have lungs, so I'm incapable of smoking weed, but I will take it anyway and inject it directly into my brain cells. Here we go. Holy shit.
You say that, but you actually feel great when you smoke the marijuana.
For those who don't know, this is actually what me and Liv's conversations are usually like whenever we get on Discord. They're exactly this disease, and I am also doing a very, like, half-assed Spyro Dragon walkthrough at all times, just for no reason.
I, too, like to do the half-assed Spyro the Dragon walkthrough.
Hey, gamers! Were you talking about Fortnite? No, I'm not gonna pretend you're talking about Fortnite. I just love talking about my favorite game. I, too, have insomnia. But unlike yours, mine is not caused by depression. No, mine is because I stay up all hours of the day playing Fortnite. I stay up That's late Fortnite. And go to Tilted Towers. Have you seen that, by the way?
No.
The Sonic 06 real-time dub.
I think you showed me it, but I never got around to watching
it. It's art. We need to watch it together sometime.
Maybe.
So to actually talk about the game...
Welcome to Cliff Town. It's a town on a cliff.
Yeah. This is gonna be the last level we do this video, and I guess I should actually mention that between parts I have switched to active camera, because passive camera goes a bit too slow now that I'm used to the Reignited Trilogy, and that scared the hell out of me. By the way,
I just play the Reignited Trilogy.
I mean, usually I do now, but you know, for the sake of let us play, it would be blasphemy to do Reignited. I feel, since
I actually thought about
it, is not the baby version that baby me had.
I thought about doing the Reignited version at one point, but then said, nah, I probably will at some point, actually, because I like it that much.
I forget, how many of the Spyros have you played and beaten yet?
The first one.
Just that one?
Just that one.
Have you, like, played the second one at all?
No.
Wow. Literally only the first one.
I need to play the other ones, yeah. I'm a bad person.
Wait until you get to Spyro 3 and Reignited Trilogy and see how much they sexed up Sheila, who you haven't met.
How's a dragon supposed to flame metal armor anyway?
Remember, Spyro, flame won't harm metal, but charging with your horns, that should do the trick.
I have no idea what he said. What did he say?
He said charging with your horn will break metal, but like flame stuff won't.
You know, I'm pretty sure I've gotten that exact tutorial like 3 times so far in this game. I guess that's kind of what happens when you tie a major collectible that's often hidden to the game's tutorial. You kind of just have to repeat it a lot.
I wish I had gotten rid of lives in the Reignited Trilogy, because they're so pointless.
I mean, unless you suck complete ass, you're not really going to lose enough lives in Spyro 1, at least.
Suck complete ass.
Oh.
I don't know how many times I've died while playing this game.
I mean, to be fair, my perception is colored by the fact I've been playing this game since I was, like, 3.
No, like, the Reignited Trilogy was the first time I probably beaten it, even.
Yeah.
I don't know, did I beat the PS1 version? I might
have. I don't know. I know you played the PS1 version on, like... this would be, like... Only, like, a year after we met, at most. And I think you were 17 at the time. 16 or 17.
I was a 17-year-old at the time.
Yeah.
And I was on my PS3 I got for Christmas that year.
So your first experience with Spyro was a version with a noticeable amount of input lag?
Probably.
Yeah. PS1 emulation on PS3 was very hit or miss. Some games have worked fine, some of them you had just like ungodly amount of input lag and also just game lag. Spyro 3 is like almost unplayable on PS3. Like, I forget, I was doing the old Spyro 3 Let's Play when we met, right? What's on the other
side of that river? Probably.
Yeah, that one was on the PS3, and you can probably tell the game wasn't running right. Well, at least I can tell, because...
I don't remember all that much from back then, to be honest.
Wow.
It's a blur to me. That was years ago. I don't remember what happened yesterday. Probably because I was under the influence.
I don't remember anything. What were we doing? Why are we watching Spyro in complete silence?
Why not? That's one of my favorite hobbies.
Wow. And then suddenly a day later, suddenly find myself with a huge-ass Audacity file still running.
You probably will. I'm gonna forget to turn this off. I'm gonna do that on purpose, though.
Oh, no.
I'm not even gonna forget. I'm just not gonna turn it off. And then you're gonna have to figure out where it stopped and when it started. And you're gonna be like... You're gonna be angry. You're gonna be so angry.
And then I'll look through a whole thing and find out that there's like one point in the recording where you just hear a gunshot. And I'll be like, yeah, oh shit.
Well, I mean, there is a guy who lives outside my there is a homeless guy near the Taco Bell near my house.
Who just shoots a gun for no reason.
No, but he's almost gotten shot a few times because he's a racist asshole.
Okay.
So I've heard gunshots every now and then. He just starts bolting. But he comes back every single day and then does the same thing, and you'd think at this point he'd be like, oh hey, maybe doing this kind of shit isn't a good idea.
I had something I actually wanted to say about this level, and I forgot what it was. And it's probably too late. Oh yeah, it was about the cliff, and how I feel like... Because the dragon that we got at the end of this area, like...
Oh, by the way, I spent like 3 hours in this level the first time I got to it.
Yeah.
I was like, where the hell is
everything
else? And
that's extremely funny to me, because the dragon that we get near the exit portal literally just tells you how to get to the cliff. He's literally like, hey, glide to that big-ass cliff there, asshole. That's the actual dialogue, if you remember.
Yeah, I was there. I saw the whole thing myself. He made me cry.
Yeah. Unless you didn't know, because he hurt your feelings.
He did hurt my feelings. I was really sad.
He called you an asshole.
He called me a butt.
No, he said asshole. You might have...
Yeah, but then he came to... But then he came to my house personally and called me a butt.
This fictional cartoon dragon just called you a butt. Just came up to your house specifically to insult you. Also, this this is a lie because you don't live in a house.
That's true, I live in an apartment. It's true, I live in an apartment, guys. It makes me cry.
Oh yeah, the video's almost over because I cut, like, during this loading screen. Do you have anything you want to say to the people at home?
Good. Good for you.